just trying to see the transformations that took place in the graph below. So let's maybe get an idea of where it started and ended. So it started at the yellow, and then it went over to the blue, and then how did I know? Because it had quantum in the fix, and then it went to the green. And so that's where it ended up going. So it went yellow to blue to green. Yellow to blue to green. So let's see how it happened. So yellow to blue looks like a reflection to me. It looks like a reflection. Now, is it the y-axis? Maybe. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it is the y-axis, alright, because that's... It's not going to set it. Because I can tell that that's right in the middle, and I can check the rest of the plate. C is 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So now I work out. So we're going to get a reflection over the y-axis. And then it goes from yellow, or sorry, blue-green, which is definitely a dilation. And I don't think that's a scale factor. So let's pick a couple of points out. Let's use C and C prime. C prime and C prime. So C prime prime is negative 1, 2, and C prime is 1, 2, 3, 4, negative 4. It's negative 2, 1, and that's negative 4, 2. Okay, so it's got to go from here to here. But again, if you're not sure, negative 4x equals negative 2, divided by negative 4, and get x equals 0.5. If you don't know, you hit the math button and pick the fraction thing. But that's a 1/2. Now, if you have a dilation of 0.5, that's fine with me. I don't care. You can't use repeating decimals. So, dilation of 1/2. Be careful, because I think sometimes we can get confused and think that it's negative 1/2 because of negative numbers, or, you know, negative 2 might make it smaller. But you got to make sure that you look at this and make sure that it actually multiplies. If you think it's other than number, you may try it out. 2 times 1/2 equals 1. That's good. Alright, negative 4 times 1/2 equals negative 2. Also good. We can check those things out to make sure that we have the valuation set up correctly.